Researchers just found microplastic in the human penis and testicles. Yeah, you heard that right. I'm Dr. Justin Houman, board-certified urologist and men's health specialist, and I see this on a weekly basis, the negative impact that microplastics can have on not just your reproductive health, but also your sexual health. And I'm here to tell you how we can fix it and prevent that from happening. But before we do that, click the subscribe and like button below so we can talk about this topic and many more men's health topics. I can tell you in my practice, I see many men who are struggling with infertility, and on a year-to-year basis, that population of men struggling with fertility issues is increasing. And although we can't necessarily directly correlate microplastics to infertility, as we see the impact of microplastics and learn more about it, it's one of those things that we really have to be mindful of. So being mindful of the things that are causing microplastic disruptions in your body and doing the things to prevent the impact of these microplastics within your body are very, very important for reproductive health, sexual health, and overall health. So the research shows that in 2024, at the University of New Mexico, they examined 23 human testicles, and in all 23 testicles, microplastics were found. Small amount of microplastics, but nonetheless, microplastics were found. About 329 micrograms per gram of testicular tissue. So where do these things come from? A lot of them are from used bags, from PVC and polystyrene. And the thing is, these get into our body, and our body has an ability to get rid of it, but at the same time, it may not have the ability to completely get rid of it, and it deposits these microplastics in different parts of our bodies. So historically, we know that microplastics deposit themselves in the lungs, the placenta, some of our organs. But this is the first time that we found microplastics in the human testicle. So it's a wake-up call that microplastics are not just all over around us, but they're invading our body, and now they're getting into the organ that's involved in reproductive health and sexual health, our testicles. A study in China in 2023 even found out that when they looked at 10 men's semen analysis, 6 of them had microplastics in the semen analysis. So they even found plastic just in the ejaculate that comes from the testicles, which again is a big wake-up call in terms of where these microplastics are going in our bodies. How do we get microplastics in our body? There's 3 main ways. So inhalation, just breathing it in through our lungs. This happens from dust, from some of the clothes that we wear, these synthetic clothing that we wear. These small particles come off these clothes, for example. We inhale them, they go into our bloodstream, and they deposit themselves in different parts of our body, our heart, our lungs, and now our testicles. Number 2, we ingest them. So we all know that bottled water carries the risk of microplastics being ingested in our body. So these plastic bottles of water, plastic, any type of bottle, sodas, different beverages, that could impact it. Even fish, we know that fish that are eating in the oceans, for example, they're consuming some of these microplastics that have polluted the oceans. And by them ingesting it, we're then ingesting these fish, and that it's increasing the concentration of some of these microplastics within our own body as our digestive systems are eating these, absorbing these microplastics, and again, they're depositing all over our bodies. So the third way is by heating. So every time we heat up some plastic that has our food in it, maybe our beverages in it, that could increase the leaching from that plastic container into that food or drink that we're ingesting. So we know that when you microwave any type of plastic, you're increasing that particle count by about 500%. So that's something to be very mindful of. Minimize or at least eliminate, try to eliminate as much microwaving as you can of plastic containers, specifically plastic food containers. So how do microplastics hurt our body, specifically from a men's health standpoint, specifically from a sexual health and reproductive health standpoint? So we know that microplastics can disrupt sperm formation. At least in animal studies, we've been able to show that there's about a 60% drop in sperm counts after plastic exposure. The only thing to be mindful of here is it's not so black and white when we say plastic exposure. It does depend on a dose-dependent amount of plastic exposure, so we're still trying to figure out what dose of that plastic exposure is actually harmful. But it is important to know that any type of plastic exposure can decrease your sperm counts as supported by these animal studies. The second thing is microplastics can interfere with hormone production. So Leydig cells are the cells within the testicle that are primarily responsible for hormone or testosterone production. And we know that microplastics can interfere with Leydig cell function. They could decrease the ability of those Leydig cells to produce testosterone levels. So in doing so, they'll lower your sperm counts. That's another way that microplastics can negatively impact men's health, specifically testosterone production. Next, Microplastics can trigger once they get into the testicle. They could increase the amount of inflammation within that testicle, and in doing so, create oxidative stress on the sperm that are being produced. The DNA within that sperm can be damaged internally, and because their DNA is damaged, the chances of that sperm being able to achieve reproductive success or to fertilize an egg, those chances are a lot lower when the DNA within that sperm is damaged. And finally, because microplastics can breach that blood testis barrier, there's a very unique barrier that separates the testicles from the rest of the bloodstream. It's called the blood testis barrier. Because microplastics are able to invade through that barrier, there's a theoretical risk of damaging that barrier, therefore allowing other toxins to come into the testicle, whereas before those toxins weren't necessarily making their way into their testicles. So all of that cascade can really negatively impact testicular function, sperm production, and hormone production within the testicle. Plastics, and specifically microplastics, can act as a Trojan horse, as they carry a bunch of endocrine disruptors into the cells of your body, your heart, your lungs, and now we know into your testicles and even into your penis. Although we're still trying to figure out the negative impact from this, the way we think about this is the more microplastics you have in the penis, specifically the erectile bodies of the penis, that could create inflammation. And what inflammation can do is it can increase the amount of scarring and the loss of the elasticity within the corporal bodies or within the erectile bodies of the penis. And that could obviously cause worsening erectile function. It could decrease the amount of blood flow into the penis and the strength of your erections, but it could also cause Peyronie's disease. We're still trying to figure this out, but we now see that there are microplastics within the penis in some men who are exposed to significant amounts of microplastics. So what are the practical takeaways from this? How do we prevent microplastics from continuing to invade our lives, our bodies, our testicles, and our penises? Couple things to think of. Number one, minimize the amount of bottled water that you're drinking. There's data to support that 93% of bottled waters have some form of microplastics in them that can be consumed or ingested when drank. Number two, try to increase the amount of wild caught fish. If you are eating a lot of fish, try to focus on wild caught fish because these fish are less susceptible to have been eating a lot of the microplastics that are currently polluting our oceans. Number three, store food in glass or stainless steel. Try to minimize the amount of plastic that you're storing food in, and in doing so, you could decrease the amount of microplastics that leach into that food. Number four, a HEPA filter air filter is quite important because what it helps do is it clears up a lot of the dust and a lot of the particles that carry microplastics that we're inhaling on a daily basis. So that really helps if you could have one at home on a daily basis, functioning, filtering out the air, that could really help decrease the amount of microplastics that we're inhaling. Number five, try to minimize the amount of synthetic fibers that you wear, because again, the synthetic fibers, it could brush off or could leach out a little bit of microplastics that again, we ingest throughout the course of our day. And finally, antioxidant rich foods like leafy greens, fruits, omega-3s, all of these can help protect the cells of our bodies from the microplastics that are in our bloodstreams and protect those cells from further risking and further impact associated with the microplastics.